So if there's one thing I see a lot in the clinic when I'm working with you guys, it's wrist pain. Now I'm sure if I were to be able to see all of your faces and we asked who here has wrist pain when they tumble, I'm sure a lot of hands would go up and potentially it would be hurting when you raise your hand. But today we're gonna go over exactly how you can eliminate wrist pain that you may feel right here when you tumble. So if you have wrist pain, stick with me because I'm gonna show you exactly how to address it. So there are a lot of moving parts in our wrist, right? I know it looks like a small little structure, but there's actually a lot of things going on here. We've got two bones from our forearm. We've got a bunch of bones here for the wrist bones, and then we've got our hand bones that come down. And all of these guys have to work in coordination with each other. Now, supporting all of these, we've also got all these ligaments. We've got a bunch of muscle tendons that comes down. There's a whole lot going on here. So one common thing that I see in our athletes is that they have wrist pain right about here when they tumble. And so I wanna show you guys a test that I use in the clinic and then talk to you guys about some strategies on how you can eliminate this pain if you pass this test. So the way that I perform this quick, easy test in the clinic and also at the gym is I'll have our athlete put their weight on their hand and press down. If that generates pain and it's pain right about here, that's usually an indication that they have an issue that we can address with the things I'm gonna show you today. Now, I gotta preface this, if you're having wrist pain, number one thing, you need to make sure you're getting this thing checked out because we don't want to overlook a serious wrist injury. And this information is just to help you if you want to try some strategies to see if you can eliminate that pain. So always want to make sure that we're getting things checked out by a doctor. So we have this pain here in our wrist. We put pressure on our hand, ouch, that hurts real bad. Now, if we take our other hand and we grab just above the two bones, the two bumps on our wrist, and we squeeze really good, and then we go and load it again, if that reduces your pain, that is what we're looking for. So what that tells me is that we've got too much movement in the wrist as a whole that is causing that pain. And by stabilizing these two bones and still loading, if it reduces the pain, that tells me that we need to improve range of motion and put our focus right here. So the way we can do that is a couple of things. Number one, you guys may have seen a lacrosse ball before. We've used these in a lot of our videos in the past. Now, a lacrosse ball is a tool that we use to work on tight, tender areas like our muscles and things of that nature. Now, you may have also seen one of these before. Now, I know this generation, everything's a lot is electronic, so a pencil is a useful tool for rehab. Now, you'll notice this lacrosse ball, which is dense rubber, and this eraser, which is dense rubber, it's almost like a miniature lacrosse ball on a stick. So the lacrosse ball may be a little too big for our wrist, but our pencil eraser is perfect. So what we would do is take our eraser and we're gonna find right where we feel that tender spot. And with our pencil eraser, we'll apply pressure and work on that tender spot just like if we had a tender spot in our muscle. So we want to press in and apply a little bit of movement to work on that tender area. Now, one common thing I see is that people will try to erase their pain. Not enough pressure with that. So we want to make sure that we're applying good pressure and it's small little movements there right where we feel that pain. Now we'd want to kind of hunt around the wrist, find those tender spots and spend enough time there with our pencil eraser that we feel a decrease in the pain that we have. Once we've gone through with our pencil eraser, then we want to get into rehabbing the wrist, again, utilizing what we found in our test, and that's if we stabilize the forearm, we can reduce that pain. And so what we'll do is we'll take our hand, grab just like we did before, applying pressure to these two bones, and we're gonna go through a wrist stretch where we put our hand down onto a flat surface. It can either be the floor or a table or a chair, and we're gonna do a wrist stretch. We're stretching into wrist extension, but stabilizing here. So what that's doing is that's getting true flexibility through this area without accessing too much range of motion or too much flexibility in this part of our forearm. So again, we stabilize, and we go through a big stretch here, pressing into our hand. Now for that stretch, anywhere from 30 to 60 seconds should be good. And again, should be less pain than it was before. Now lastly, we'll take our band and we want to work on strengthening the muscles of our forearm that come across the wrist, but again, utilizing that squeeze. So what we do is we take our band, put a loop on it so we can grab it. We would step on the other end of the band and bring our band up to here. Now you can rest your arm on a table or a chair if you have access to that, or you can do it just hanging out open in space. We would grab our two bones here and we're gonna work on wrist extension while stabilizing the two bones in our forearm. Again, reducing the pain that comes from this extension. So we'd squeeze here and we do anywhere from 10 to 15 repetitions of our wrist extension. Once we get done, we wanna ice our wrists so we can reduce the pain and inflammation that comes with wrist pain. But by implementing these couple of things into your wrist rehab, you can dramatically reduce the pain that you have when you tumble. Now again, can't emphasize enough, make sure don't take this advice only as the only thing you're doing for your wrist. Make sure if it's really giving you trouble that you check with a doctor. We don't wanna overlook wrist injuries, especially this area, because they can lead to chronic problems down the road. But if you're just having this wrist pain, you've had it checked out by a doctor and they say there's nothing major going on and that you should rehab it, is a perfect way to get started. Thank you so much for joining me for this video. I really hope you don't have wrist pain, but I know that a lot of athletes do. So if you do have wrist pain, give this a shot. I wanna hear if it gives you some help. It does help a lot of the athletes that I work with in the clinic, and it should be able to help you as well. If you'd like more videos on wrist pain, check out the link below. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. It's got the Hit Zero logo, our triangle. And if you haven't checked out hitzeronutrition.com, you're being silly, because Hit Zero Nutrition is wellness and nutrition company made just for you guys, right? For cheer athletes, made just for you. So go check that out too. There'll be a link in the description below, and we will catch you on our next video.